Hey, my love.
How are you doing this morning, my love?
Hey, calm down. All right? Okay, just be quiet. Stop panicking, all right? It's gonna be okay. STOP PANICKING!
That's better. So,
did you get enough sleep? That's why I drugged you in the first place, so we could come here. And yeah, I didn't tell you. We are in Hawaii. This is our new home. This is our condo. Well, I knew we would have to leave before anyone else found out about what happened to Mike? You don't remember?
You don't remember that bastard who tried to take you from me?
You don't remember him? That's probably a good thing, actually. Screaming. The pain. The cries. I felt it all. I could tell it hurt, by the way. You see, Mike was getting in
my... No, my beloved. Our way.
Besides, I knew he wasn't the one for you. That's only me. Am I right?
Am I right? Good.
You do look ravishing this morning. You look very good looking, actually. Not that, you know, not, you're not, I mean, not that you're not pretty, I just, I am, I feel, am I getting hot? Are you hot? I mean, of course you're hot, I mean, you're beautiful. You're so good looking. You're a wonderful, wonderful person. But that's not the reason why I chose you. Not based on your good looks, which you do have. No.
No, my love.
It was because
you were perfect in every single way.
So hot. And I am so glad I got you. I mean, how could I not get you? You know me.
Don't you? Don't you?
Oh. Well, you get the point. So let me, fill you in. You see, I grew up, and I was lonely when I grew up. Everyone just bullied me, said I was stupid. Everyone thought I was just some loser. Everybody just hated me. Not as much as I hated Mike, who... Oh yeah, he's dead, by the way. Yeah, I killed him. murder him right in front of you. Kind of had to make a point, by the way. Yeah, but it was... okay, it was pretty painful. Well, for him, at least. For me? No, it was satisfying.
As soon as I kill that man... that bastard...
as soon as I herded him,
as I began to torture him, I could hear his screams thundering throughout the world.
People walking by assumed that it was nothing. But I couldn't take my chances. Why we had to leave. But they bullied me. Long. For days. Then it turned to weeks, to months, to years. I hated it. I hated all of it. I suffered. Like he has suffered.
He deserved it. I hope you know that.
That bastard. That son of a bitch. That fucking asshole tried to take you from me. And I will not let anyone do that. If they so much as even look in my beloved, I will kill them with my bare hands. I will snap their neck and I will choke them as the life fades from them.
I love it.
Killing to me is
fascinating. To take one's life gives you a rush, doesn't it? Well, someday you will learn.
And if you cooperate,
I may just give you a kiss. I love your lips. They're so delicious. Tasty. I could just sit here and eat them all day.
But after a while, after the years of constant bullying, I didn't take it anymore. I decided to stand up against my bullies. They hurted me. They made fun of my family. My younger brother and sister.
My mother and father, my grandparents.
One of them managed to throw a firecracker at my grandmother. But that's when the line had to be drawn. You see, when you're as... well, I wouldn't say crazy. I prefer creative. I went over to their house. All three of the bastards.
With a machete.
The first one tried to hit me with a bat. I managed to deflect it and, well, throw the bat away. Then,
I cleaved his head off with one swing as I saw the blood spurt out of his throat, his jugular. I went over and put my finger in the blood and licked it as a taste test. And it was delicious. I love it. Then I covered myself in the man's blood to scare the others, to show them don't fuck with me. But their fate was already sealed. I ran for one of the other ones. I managed to get a hold of him. I lifted him up into the air. Threw him in through the wall. Came out the other side. I am a lot stronger than I look. After that, I went over to him. I grabbed a rope and I hung him from the rafters as I stabbed him and watched the blood rip out of his body, coating the floor. It was beautiful. It was like a painting. Blood everywhere. Gory and gruesome. You will listen. Is that right? Good. After I killed that one, I went for the last one. Who hurt her? And when you're me, you never hurt. Because if you do, you will be dead. I will find and hunt them down to my last breath. And I will kill them and torture them slow, painfully, and with great joy. I will kill them and leave them where they are.
Quite enjoyable, actually.
To cripple one. To render them of nothing
but pain, nothing. Then I broke both of his arms. I made him crawl for the open door. And just when it seemed like he would get out, I stabbed him in the back with the machete. Repeatedly. And I cut him in half. Like he was nothing. Like a stick of worthless, stupid butter. But the best part was when I picked up the bat. I crippled him. Then I hit him in the balls and ruptured his testicles. Then I finished the job by caving the man's skull in. Till there was no skull left. Just a pile of blood. Then I lit the house on fire and left.
based on my master plan. I got the cops to believe it was just them joking around. But you know. But now we're here, my love. In Hawaii. Here, I'll open the door for you. Just look. It's beautiful, isn't it? Oh, and the view from here. I'm talking about the ocean. It's beautiful. Would you like to go down there and have a swim? I'd love to do that if you want to. But if you run, try to escape. Well, let's just say I'll take care of you and bring you back here and chain you up. Do you understand? Go ahead and tell me that. Do you understand? Good. I love you. And I will love you till the day I die. Till the day we die. If you somehow die, I don't know what I'd do. But if someone takes my beloved and they kidnap them, I will kill them relentlessly. And if I can't have you, no one can. People just don't understand, I guess. Madly in love with the person I care about. I care more than most men and women. Everybody just believes me as a man. I'm just in love. With my beloved. You love me too, don't you? Beloved? I believe I asked you a question. Do you love me? Do you love me? Listen to me. Read my lips. Do you love me? Do you? Do you? Do you? Good. I got a little scared there for a second. It's good to know your heart's in the right place. I'm not blushing. What are you talking about? I'm not a tsundere, though. I'm just madly in love. So, how about we go? I believe you've earned yourself a nice little break.
manage to buy you a new swimsuit. I hope you like it. Think of this as our summer vacation. You know, before we get married here at least. Yes, we're getting married. Here's your ring. Will you please marry me? You're crying. Why are you crying? Oh, it's probably just because you're in love so much. Here you go, my beloved. It looks beautiful on you. I love you. Besides, after we're married, we can make a family. We can have kids. Isn't that incredible? I know, I can't wait. Oh, I love my life. And I love you, my beloved. Now get dressed, let's go swim.